first started writing, and I think this is a lot of new writers make the same mistake, is you write your book, you write that first draft, and you think, wow, I've written a book here, you know, I've written a novel, I've finished it. You haven't. It's the first draft, and it's usually rubbish. But it's something there that you can work on, and that you can refine, and you can edit. And I usually go through about 8 revisions before I'm happy with it. And the last revision I go through, I check all the words, I check all the phrases, I check all the facts that I've got right. And you can see that by the time I get to number 8, I know that story inside out, upside down, back to front. I know it so well that I can no longer see the holes in it, can I? I'm just too close to it. So when I get to that stage, sometimes I'll read it through and I think, this isn't bad, it's quite good. Other times I'll read it through and I'll go, oh, what a load of rubbish. Oh, what am I going to do? Chuck it all out and start again, which I can't do. I've got to actually get to the stage where I think I can do no more with it. And that's when it goes off to my publisher with my fingers crossed. So my fingers crossed that they like it. Because you never know. They could come back to me and they could say, we like it, but, that awful word, but, oh no. We like it, but it's too long, we don't like this, we don't like that, can you take this out? Now fortunately, touch wood, that's never happened to me, or not happened to me yet. They come back to me and they say, we really like it and we'd like to publish it, X, Y, Z. So that's really great, because if they come back and they say, we like it, but we'd like you to change this, with a crime novel, you see, if you change one thing, you change everything, because everything has to link together. So it's quite a major rewrite, so I'm very fortunate that that doesn't happen. It will then go to copy edit stage, which is when it will come back to me for checking. The editor might have suggested using a different word here, or a different word there, or a phrase, or if I've not explained something clearly, they'll point that out to me, and they'll also put it in their house style and check punctuation. So then I get a chance to read through it again and to make any changes. I don't have to accept their changes, it's entirely up to me, but quite often what they suggest is really very good and can tighten the novel up. So a good editor is worth his or her salt. I also get asked about how I research a novel, and I do my research as I go along, as I write. Some authors will research and plot the whole novel out before they start writing. I think the late P.D. James was one of them. Now, if I spend time plotting everything, doing all my research before I start the creative writing, I know I would never write that book, because by then I'd be bored with it. So I do like to research as I go along. And I do a lot of research on the internet, which is very helpful for crime writers. And here, for example, I won't put you off your lunch, but this little bit here is called Corpse in the Water. So that's all about decomposing corpses in the water. It's very nice, isn't it? I'm my person. I hope the police never come into my house, because I think they'll think I'm a serial killer. I have so much information on how to kill people. I do have a very good source of information in Bob, my husband, because unfortunately in his job he's seen a lot of corpses in all sorts of situations, not very pleasant. So, not that he talks about it, but if I can get some information out of him, and he's also been to post-mortems, so I get quite a lot of information from him. But I've got Corpse in the Water here, and that's quite applicable, because my books are set around the sea, and there's always a body somewhere in the water. And this one is Fire and Bodies Burned. So again, you can see that I've got a lot of inside information on fires, from Bob, and it's about bodies in a fire. And this one, if you're looking at this, it says a peculiar case of bullet, burns and boot. So that's about a body that was found in the boot of a car that had been set alight to try and disguise a murder. So there's lots of information, but I also get lots of information from Hampshire Police. And I have to say that Hampshire Police are absolutely superb. They have been with me from day one when I was not a published author. I didn't have a book to my name, and I wrote to them and contacted them and said, can I come talk to some of you guys and find out about how you work and everything? They said, yeah, come down to the station. And they've been great. And I run an event called CSI Portsmouth every year, or most years, where I bring together crime authors and police and forensic experts. And I've been running that for 5 years, and now I have a superb network of forensic experts and Hampshire police officers who I can always email and contact. And they are very, very helpful indeed, so they can give me lots of information. Of course, they're not true to life. When I do a book signing or a talk, and somebody comes up to me and says, oh, I'm in the police force, and go, oh no. I say, it's fiction. They go, no, don't worry about it, we know it is. It's not true police work. Although in America, one of the reviewers for a book magazine in America said, my novels reflect true British police procedure. I thought, no, they don't. That might be how you see it, but it's not real. But they think it is, so that's fine. So it does, you know, I try to be as accurate as I can, but obviously in a real investigation, there'd be a whole team of police officers, and there would be a lot going on, and a lot of paperwork, etc. But if you put that in a crime fiction novel, no one's going to read it, because it'd be dead boring. So I research as I go along, so that's roughly how I write and how I plot and how I plan. As you can see, there's a lot of work in it, and I'm quite systematic. That's the way I work. But of course, you could have another author next week talking to you who would work in a completely different way. So it's all about finding your style and what works for you. And it's great fun. I really enjoy it.